2D lists are an important data structure with many applications. Some of the more common ones are listed on the slide. So for example, any situation where we have a grid, such as screen pixels, or in our case in this project, the representation of game boards and mazes and such like. Also mathematical programming, where if we want to represent matrices. And basically whenever you have any kind of tabular data, so the kind of data you would store in a table, like in a spreadsheet, that's other places where 2D lists are very useful, and there's a few others listed. A 2D list can be thought of as a list of lists. As with 1D lists, in Python the elements can be of mixed type, although this is fairly uncommon. So take a look at this visual representation. We have a list definition in code here. My list is equal to list containing list, another list, and another list. And beneath that we have a visualization or a visual representation of how that would be stored inside of Python. So take a look at this. You can see that in the global frame, that means accessible to our whole program, we have my list defined, which is pointing to a list which has three items. So that's indices 1, 2, and 3. Now index 0 of that first list is pointing to another list which contains the integers 1, 2, and 3. Index 1 of that first list is pointing to another list which contains A, B, and C. And index 2 of that first list is pointing to a third list that contains the Boolean values true, false, and true. Many of the algorithms associated with pathfinding work with graphs. By graphs, I mean the sort associated with graph theory in mathematics, rather than in the sense of graphs and charts that you may be more familiar with. We will see in this video that a maze stored in a 2D list can represent a special type of graph, where each cell in the list corresponds to a node and adjacent cells are connected by edges. So this is a very quick crash course in graphs if you haven't come across them before. So basically we have nodes and edges, and in this image on the slide you can see we're using letters to represent the nodes and they're connected by edges, which are the green lines. Now there are different types of graph. You can get directed and undirected. So a directed graph is one where the direction between the nodes matters, and undirected is where it doesn't matter. Also, you can have weighted graphs where each of the edges can have a different weight. Now, in our particular situation, we're going to use undirected graphs that are unweighted. So they're fairly simple compared to other types of graphs out there. Now, this gives you an idea of how we're going to represent this graph in a 2D list. So we have each of the cells is going to be a node, and the nodes are going to be connected by edges. Again, in the next slide, you can see we have the same situation, except here there's also the possibility of having an obstacle. So some of the cells are going to be inaccessible. Because of that, on this slide, they're drawn in a different color, and also there's no edges connecting the other nodes to the obstacle nodes. Now, it is very important that you familiarize yourself with IJ index notation for 2D lists. So let's talk about how that works. So differently to what you might be familiar with XY coordinates, you can see on the slide here on the left we have Cartesian coordinates where the horizontal is the X and the vertical is the Y, and we increase to the right for the X and we increase upwards for the Y coordinate. Whereas in matrix coordinates, grid coordinates, it's a slightly different system. So first of all we have the vertical coordinate first, and that's because we're basically talking in terms of rows. Okay, so the I coordinate is the row number. And you'll notice that it also, as it increases, it goes down rather than up, because row 1 is further down our grid than row 0. And then for the J, that's pretty much like the old X coordinate, so that increases left to right. So for example, you can see on the right hand side of this slide that we have a dot at coordinates I equals 4, J equals 2. That means row 4, column 2. So for a bit more practice on that, we have here a grid representation of a maze where the X's are the cells that we can't access or the obstacles. S would be the start position and G would be the goal position. So you can see that S is at position 1, 1, which means row 1, column 1, whereas G is at position 7, 5, which means row 7, column 5. Okay, so again, just to emphasize, this is different to XY coordinates. Now, in terms of representing these lists inside of Python, obviously from a human perspective, it makes sense to talk in terms of rows, but internally that distinction isn't made. So you can see the second representation here. It's the same grid, that same maze is represented in a horizontal list of lists. And then the third example there is just the output you would get if you went through the rows and printed one row at a time. So just to reiterate, the first representation there is how you might type it into Python and how you might think about it in terms of rows. The second one is more like how it's represented inside of the computer. And the third one is just each of the individual rows printed out. And then finally, we have here a screenshot of a tiny maze represented inside of a text file. In this case, it's inside Notepad++. So we have the line numbers. Then we have the tiny dots representing spaces. And the asterisks are representing obstacles within the maze. Now you know how to represent and store a maze in a 2D list. If at any point you get confused about 2D list indices, come back and watch this video again to remind yourself how they work. It's a bit like orienting a map. Once you have the direction fixed, finding your way becomes relatively simple.